What's good, fam? It's your boy Guns. Man, the show last night, bruh, for Lucha Underground, it was pretty good, bruh. It's the fourth episode of the season, and I know I didn't give you guys a review for the third episode. I was so disappointed of the show. It was so bad, and that I wasn't moved into doing a review because the show was it was ass. But this show this week was pretty good, man. It was the best episode so far this season, and it had some good matches. Like the first match was the triple threat match between Angelico, Son of Havoc, and Idiotis against Castro, Chavo, and the other Shelby fat dude, forget his name. But it was a good match, man. The Angelico made the match. He was pretty much the all-star of that match. And it was a good match for an opening match, man. It was pretty good. Then in the second match, Cage faced a new wrestler named Joey. Now, this Joey character, he's supposed to be a police officer that works together with Castro, because Castro is supposed to be a police officer that is undercover investigating Huertas. So, you know, Castro, this happened on the third episode, the one I didn't review. But Castro is working a case to build a case against Huerta, and apparently, you know, his captain she's not too happy with his performance, so she sent him some help, and this is where Joey comes in, and he wasn't too bad, man. He was pretty good. You know, I like his swag, his character is pretty nice. It's not cheesy like the Moth. That Moth character belongs in WWE, man. I mean, it's really bad. I don't like it. I think it's stupid. But the whole storyline is stupid to me, between me. The way they went about it, you know, between him and the Moth I forgot her name. Anyway, that female wrestler, the famous one. That whole storyline when he keep nice her and this and that, it's kind of stupid. They're coming back with that next week, by the way. But the kidnap part was good. It's just his character is corny. You feel me? It's like you had this corny character doing these criminal activities. It's just stupid. I don't get it. And it's stupid and corny to me. So, but anyway, back to the last episode. The Joey guy ended up wrestling Cage, and Cage is a beast, man. I'll tell you something, man. Cage reminds me a lot of Goldberg. Not in the way that he wrestled or his physique, just his demeanor, man. His demeanor is just like Goldberg. I remember when Goldberg came into the scene at WCW, man, he had this demeanor that he's gonna kick everybody's ass. Anybody that gets in his way, he's gonna kick the ass. He's gonna hurt them. And Cage got that same demeanor, man. That's what I like Cage so much, man, because he is there to hurt people. And it's incredible. You know, you can believe that it's because the man is huge and he's very talented. So, you know, Joey debut was pretty good, but Cage destroyed him. It is what it is, you know. It takes a special wrestler to beat Cage. He's a beast. But anyway, the main event. Oh man, the main event of Lucha Underground: Pentagon Jr. against Prince Puma. Now that was a good match. Prince Puma did his thing. Pentagon Jr., man. Pentagon Jr. is my favorite wrestler in Lucha Underground. hands down, to me, he's my favorite wrestler because he's very innovative and very credible, you know, in the way that he do his character. He's very credible. He's well done. You can see the spirit shine through and the effort that he puts on his character. You can see that he loves what he's doing, man, because of the way he carries himself in that ring and the way he, you know, he portrays his character. That's why, for me, man, Pentagon Jr., man, best character and best wrestler in Lucha Underground, hands down. But Puma is pretty good, man. He's got a lot of talent, and they put up a good show, man. It was a good match. It seems to me a bad hurry because of they spent too much time in between. They spent too much time during the second match between Cage and Joey. I think that match lasted a little bit too long, because I would like to see Prince Puma and Cage go at it a little bit longer. That would have made a better match, but it was a good match nonetheless. You know, you can't really complain. Man, my aim is horrible with this thing. But anyway, I think it was it was the best episode of the season so far. But I can see that I'm noticing that the crowd is not into it like it was on the first season. Everybody's catching up to this lack of effort in these episodes, and you can hear the crowd is not as rowdy as it used to be, and it's kind of losing his magic, man. He's losing his magic, and I'm worried, man, because most likely this is gonna be the last season. It's gonna be it. Because I can see it's losing steam. It's instead of gaining steam, it's losing steam. And people are not like into it like it used to. And the episodes are kind of stale and boring. I mean, what can you say? The matches are not as entertaining as they used to be. The characters, you know, they're focusing on the main focus is on the storyline. Just like WWE, and it's a big mistake in their part. In my, you know, they are nice storylines. The promos are really good, better than WWE's. But you know, we want to see wrestling. We don't want to see. I mean, personally, I want to see those exciting matches. You know, with the tricks and the acrobatics and the high risk moves. That's what I want to see. That's why I watch the product. You know, the promos are just icing on the cake, you know. But we'll see, man. It's getting better. I can't wait for next week episode to see what it's going to be like. Now, we know already the main event is going to be Johnny Mundo against Cage. And that should be a good match, as long as Johnny Mundo don't get lazy on us and perform. So, we'll see, man. I can't really wait to see what's gonna happen, but let me finish this match right here, man. I give the show a C. Now the third season, just because I didn't review it, I give the show a D on the third episode. That was not this week, but the week before, not this Wednesday, but the one before this Wednesday. I didn't give you guys a review. I'm going to tell you right now, that show was a D, hands down a D. It was very boring. The best part of the show was the promo at the end when they, you know, tell everybody that Castro was a cop. And that was the best part of the show. But this one right here from last Wednesday, I give it a C. It was decent. But I don't know how long I'm gonna sit here and wait for A's and B's. We need some A's and B's on this show, man. So hopefully next show will be a good show, a really good show, and we'll see, man. Anyway, if you want to see any highlights of the Lucha Underground, I post highlights on Instagram. You know, go check me out. Follow me on Instagram. You know, and the link is on my YouTube page. Just click on it, bro, and follow me on Instagram. Every Wednesday, I'll post little highlights of the show. I know that not everybody got the Rey Network, so I'm trying to pull up highlights of special moves, and they can only be 15 seconds long. So follow me on Instagram, bro. You get those highlights. I wish I could post them here, but I can't. So anyway, I got the Cerberus late. I've been making some dumb mistakes in this game. It's keeping me from getting those high kills, high scores. But it is what it is, man. Anyway, thank you for watching, and see you guys next time, man. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, and show you the score real quick. 23-3. Look at that. Nice.